Hey there everyone, my name is Eduardo Arroyo, but you can call me Ed. And today we're visiting murals just like this one here in Laredo, Texas. Yes, you guys, you heard that right. Today we're exploring murals here in my hometown of Laredo, Texas. It's been a whole year since the last video I posted about this city, which is crazy. Time flies by so quick. But with that said, I do have a playlist of other Laredo theme videos that I've done in the past. So if you are interested in more Laredo content, make sure to check the link in the description down below. Anyways, you guys, today's all about murals, and I'm sure most of you know what that is, but for you who don't, I'll just tell you real quick that murals are basically any piece of artwork that is painted or applied to a surface or wall. Murals can be simple, they can be very complex, they can be historical in nature. The possibilities are just endless. So today we're going to be checking some of the ones I know about here in Laredo. So if you guys are interested, come with me. Hello there everyone, we're just making it to the first mural that I want to show you today, and we are currently located at the edge of downtown here in the city. I say the edge of downtown because that over there, that is the Rio Grande, and right across it is Nuevo Laredo, Tamaulipas in Mexico, which is pretty cool I think. And we're also here right behind the outlet shops in downtown, right next to their parking lot. Let me show you the first mural of today. Chon chon chon, it's this one right over here. So this mural reads, "No dejes de soñar," which translates to never stop dreaming. And there's also a thought bubble. Let's see what it says. Here's a thought bubble and it reads, "Mi sueño es," which is "my dream is" in English. The way you're supposed to use it is actually laid out here on the side of the mural. Basically, you're supposed to stand on this square so that you're in the right position for a picture. So how does it look, guys? Does it give you a good vantage point? Does it really seem like I'm thinking of what my dream is? Well, that's kind of the point. I really like this mural because it's supposed to be interactive. You can come by, do some shopping at the outlets, and then come take a picture in this very cool mural. And it's also a cool reminder to never stop following your dreams. So the next mural that I want to show you is actually inside of the outlets here in downtown. And it's this one right behind me. And I think it goes kind of with the same theme as the last one that I showed you. It's kind of inspirational. There's some words at the top. They read, "When the world says give up, hope whispers keep going." Oh my goodness, poetic, inspirational. And you can kind of see the gimmick, right? You can pretend you have wings and fly away from the haters, fly away from your problems, or whatever you want. The next mural we're visiting is on the wall of the Rialto Hotel, which is very close to the bus station here in downtown. If we look right across the street, that is Jarvis Plaza, and right next to Jarvis Plaza is the bus station. I actually made a video about the bus system here in Laredo many, many moons ago, so I'll include it in the description if you want to check that out. But we're here for a mural, and I think you can kind of see it now. It's this one right behind me. So this mural right here depicts el abrazo, or the hug, which is part of a tradition here in Laredo, Texas, as part of the Washington birthday celebration. Part of the tradition is that Nuevo Laredo, Tamaulipas in Mexico and Laredo, Texas here in the US have a kid dressed in traditional attire. So as you can see, the girl is wearing a traditional Mexican dress and the little boy is wearing some sort of like uniform that the United States used to wear at some point in history. And so the basic gist of this tradition is that both cities have the kids walk to each other, they meet in the middle, and they give each other a friendly hug. And this hug symbolically represents the friendship and the close ties between the two cities. I think it's really meaningful, and I mean, look at it, it's beautiful. I wanna show it to you up close. And as you can see, the shading work that has been done to these plants makes them look great. The colors are so vibrant. Check out the dress. The same can be said about the dress. It looks really nice. And I mean, the picture of the little kids, it's super sweet. They have the flags of Mexico and the US to show that symbolism that I talked about. More symbolism surrounding them are the 7 flags that have been flown over this city. And to top it off, at the top it says El Abrazo in Spanish because of our heritage. To get to our next mural, we don't even have to walk that much. So this is the Rialto Hotel. The mural is on this wall over here. And if you turn over here, you can see the next mural is right here, right across, a block away, I guess you could say. Check it out. I think you can already tell it's huge, but just for perspective, this building is apartments for the elderly, I believe. And this mural covers a whole side of it, which is crazy. There's a lot of sections, which I'll go over in a bit. But first of all, I just want to appreciate it from afar. Doesn't it look cool? Let's go check it out a little bit closer. So I guess we can start with this light blue section here at the bottom. What this represents is all the different peoples that have made Laredo their home at some point in history. As you can see, there's a line of people coming all the way over there. And if we go to the other side, we get to present day Laredo. Check it out. At the top of the panels, you will see a flag. There's 7 panels which represent the 7 flags that have been flown over Laredo, Texas, which is a prevalent theme that you will see if you ever visit this city. That flag is the Spanish flag right there. The other flags in chronological order include France, Mexico, the Republic of the Rio Grande, which Laredo was the capital of. So another fun fact for you. The Republic of Texas, of course, the Confederate States, and last but not least, the United States flag. I love the history behind it. I like the story that it tells about Laredo and its people. Not only that, but it also tells us about the significance of this city for both the US and Mexico across the years. And I really believe in that statement right there. Our story is our power. And I think this mural does a great job at reminding us just that. I'm back. I am currently located here at the Laredo Public Library. As you can see, there's a big sign right here. And right behind the sign, I'm sure you can already see it, there's some murals right there. So we're gonna check them out and see what they're all about. So these set of murals right here were made to honor Hispanic writers who had a big influence in Latino culture. I'm gonna go ahead and go all the way to the left side so we can go one by one so I can show you who they're honoring here and the types of art styles that they included as part of these murals. So let's go check it out. The first one right here honors Sandra Cisneros. This one honors Gabriel Garcia Marquez. This one right here in honor of Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz, that is Miguel de Cervantes, Sancho Panza, and Don Quixote. This woman right here is Isabel Allende. And last but not least, Rudolfo Anaya. And before you sit there thinking like, damn, this guy was able to identify each and every one of them just by looking at them, that's not the case. I actually had to ask my girlfriend to help me with some of these people, even though I did take Spanish during high school. So I do have an appreciation for the works of these people. I did get to read some of the books, so at least there's that. And I do think it was a great idea by the city of Laredo and the Laredo Public Library to put these up, to pay someone to honor these people so that when people come by, they're like, oh, who is that? You know, and they can start the conversation. So good on them. Hey there, you guys, we made it here to the Bartlett Soccer Complex. As the name describes it, this place has some soccer fields in the area, but that's not why we're here for. We're here for murals, and let me show you, if we turn around just real quick, we can get the views of very cool murals. Check it out. So the first mural I'm gonna show you in this area is this one of a phoenix. The phoenix has to be one of my favorite mythological creatures. It's just so cool, and this mural right here gets to capture some of that like majesticness of it. So I love this mural. It looks pretty cool. So the first mural that we see over here is of Jovita Hidar. Jovita Hidar was a historical figure who was born in Laredo, Texas. I've been living in Laredo for a long time and I didn't even know that. So I think it's great they can bring awareness to these historical figures via these murals. So this mural is honoring her life from 1885 to 1946. Over here we have a more serious mural. As you can see, it's about the Mexican-American War. This one is about the Laredo Holding Institute. These last two are also of Jovita Hidar and the many causes that she fought for when she was alive. So this is another way to honor her and to remember her legacy so she's not forgotten. Check it out, you guys. I think we just got to the mecca of murals here in Laredo. There's a lot of murals on that side. There's one here that keeps going. I'll show you in a bit. And there's one right across the street as well. So we're gonna be checking all of them out and see what we can find. So this one right here is one of the long ones. As you can see, it goes what it seems like forever. And I like it. I like the colors. It's more like abstract. You can see like the different like big shapes and like the different colors. I really like it a lot. I think this is going for like the flora and fauna of Laredo and the region as well. Check it out, you guys. So this is the end, but we came from all the way over there. So this is a long mural, and I think it's the same size as the one across the street. Maybe this one is bigger actually. This one is more like realistic. The other one was more abstract, like I said, shapes and colors. But this one, like the detail that they put on this one, it's crazy. I think I like this one a little better than the other one. I like both, but this one is so cool, like the realism of it. All right, you guys, let's go check out the other side. There's some, like I said, there's a wall over there covered in murals, so let's go check it out. Wow, check these ones out, you guys. I really like the thick outline on them, especially when they're black. Check it out. You can see all the different details. I can really appreciate this art style right here. And yeah, this is the end of the first mural. I think this was all done by one person because of the art style, and I really like it. So this one, you guys, has a message behind it, or this is how I'm interpreting, I should say. So basically this is the river, right? And there's a faucet pouring straight into a glass of water. And what this means to me is that we need to take care of this natural resource because we might end up drinking it or using it for something important. So we have to learn to take care of it and teach other people to take care of our natural resources. So this one I'm gonna need some help with, to be honest. I don't understand. Basically, there's this guy smoking from a pipe, and this smoke is going all the way to the mouth of this lady over here, this young woman. Maybe it's going the other way. I don't get it. I like the art style. So the last mural that I see in this area, in this San Isidro Park area, is this group of four birds right here. They look like graffiti. You can see like the splatter of paint through it. It looks very modern and cool. I like it. I could see this as like a poster in someone's room or something. And the brothers over here. And there's some creepy sections here too, so don't come at night. I think it's time to go to our last location of the day, but San Isidro Park, I liked it and I strongly recommend. All right, you guys, so we're just getting here to the last mural that we're gonna be checking out today. This one is called Nuestro Laredo, or Our Laredo, translated to English. It's a long one, so I'm not gonna be able to show it to you all at once, but we can go by sections and I can explain what these mean or the way I interpret them. So I'm gonna place the camera right here so that I can be on the other side. All right, you guys, so we made it to the other side of the road. Like I said, this mural is called Nuestro Laredo Mural, so Our Laredo. And the theme of this mural, it reminds me of the ones that we saw over at San Isidro Park. Remember, with the native plants and animals, except I think this one, it's mostly just about plants. And so just before we take a closer look at this mural, I wanted to tell you a little bit about the history. So this mural is actually covering an older mural. There used to be one here with a lot of parrots. So a lot of birds covering the entire side. And I remember seeing that ever since the first time that I arrived here in Laredo, Texas, which was like all the way to 2007. Let me bring the camera and I'll show you up close. Oh my goodness, guys. It's like so awkward to be recording with so many cars passing by, but hopefully you guys were able to see something. Now we're gonna get up close and I'm gonna show you kind of like the different colors, the different plants that are featured in this mural. So let's take a look. And the last section that I want to show you right here is this one. And that's because this one relates to the story that I was telling you guys about. Remember that I told you that this mural is replacing a one that had a lot of parrots? Over there at the top, you can see there's a few parrots. So those are from the original. And as you can see, it hasn't been finished. That is the case too for that slim section all the way over there. And one last thing, there's also like some figures of parrots right there on the ground at the top there. And that is also a callback to the mural that used to be here before. All right, you guys, the sun is coming down so fast now, and I'm kind of losing my voice trying to speak over all these cars passing by. Let me get over to the other side to say goodbye. Oof, made it. All right, you guys, that is the end of the video. I'm gonna ask you that if you guys enjoyed, please subscribe to my channel if you wanna check out more interesting travel videos like this in the future. Hopefully you like this video. Hopefully you like the murals. Tell me which one is your favorite. And if you're planning to do this same tour, maybe in the future, let me know in the comments down below. And of course, remember that I have a playlist of Laredo videos in my channel. So if you guys are interested, please check those out in the description. And with that, I say goodbye, but first, I want to remind you to always be kind, have an open mind. I'll see you next time.